Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to part 10 of our Norsken Wulfric campaign. We're doing pretty well. We just came into a lot of money. We just had a great turn last turn. So let's end things off and upgrade everyone who needs an upgrade. I have the gods, why not? Let's go. Which one are you? Can't find that out anymore, which is a pain. Let's give you this then.
King Antres.
I've little time for talking, but.
What do you want? I'm already pissed off at you, Britannians, for not giving me your upgrades when I kill you. You just kill our general. No, you tried. Ooh, nice. Nice, nice, nice.
Battle time is feeding time.
I mean, while we're here.
Wiping them out.
So what are we on? Come on, 12, 18, 38. It's got to be the serpent. Oh, you moved into Zavastra to try and save it. Nicely done. Can't tell who would win in a fight between these two armies. We could shut down the mortar and their cav fairly quickly. It would just be great swords versus berserkers and a few of our champions. Be an interesting fight. I wonder if they'd come out and do it. We just did the serpent. I think we want to do the crow. Next, the hound.
Take what's theirs. Your will.
Let's get. Yeah, let's reduce armor. Let our berserkers do some more killing. Really have no idea how the Empire's doing. We haven't seen Karl Franz, we haven't seen any of the Empire legendary lords, I don't think. Hopefully we don't lose a unit here. That's what I don't want to do. Ah, we lost the dogs. That's all right, that's not too bad. We can get them back.
Put on the flower of Briconia, wilts beneath your feet. Turn over every stable, armory, and storehouse in the city to learn of their resourceful and chivalric ways.
Now, I suppose we could build this as a kind of recruitment area. This can go up to level 5. We'll build a growth one to speed up the rate at which this recovers. And then next we'll take this city. Bro can't move, Eric can't move. Don't think any of our armies can actually move at this stage. Pit of Shades. He's going to need this going forward. We'll do Woundmaker as well.
My
All right, you join our man over here.
You come, I'm you.
And then, how far can you go? That looks about the limit. It looks like we are about to hit some untouched dwarven cities, some very poorly protected ones as well. Excellent, 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 excellent. We may as well move a touch forward. So I think it's actually going to take us a while to get up here. Nice, 1,229. You've raised that city.
Moving out. In agreement.
Don't know if it's really worth waiting. Ironbag already has some, yeah, pretty good, pretty solid, pretty happy about that.
My challenge, undeniable.
Now we're going to occupy this. Ooh, interesting. Wolfclaw banner, plus 5% weapon strength. Causes terror. That's pretty good. We do have this whole province now, which is very handy as well. Alright, that's Wolfric's turn. Oh, I forgot. Had enough of him cheesing his way through this. Back on foot, Wolfric, please. Gold taker. That's where you're going. You're going there double time. We do that. I'm not too worried about that double stack there, because we do get the defensive bonus if we're encamped. So let's just end the turn. Okay, wizard man, what can we do for you now? Minus 20% around self constant. Oh, that's pretty solid. Not great for you, though. But where's our big guy? Potion of foolhardiness. Not anymore. There you go. Fire resistance might be handy against some of these dwarves. What's he got now? Income plus 10%. That's the only reason I'd be keeping it. We'll keep an eye on that and see if we go up against any fiery units in the near future.
I travel the world seeking jewels.
No, you must be joking, Britannia. Oh, you came for me. Interesting. Got the two skin wolves against Empire Knights. They should be able to handle that. got the chariot and the skinwalls to chase down these thunderers. Then it's just a matter of having the berserkers hold on long enough that they can take down the swords. This could be an interesting fight. Let's do it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Kislev are trying to rain on our parade. So let's see what we're going to do about it. So here I'm actually trying to use the terrain to our advantage. Now they do have a mortar, which we can't do much about, but there's this lip of terrain here and we're going to try and line our guys up for the most part. We are leaving forward a unit as a sacrifice to try and draw the attention of the mortar, but the rest of our line is a little bit further back, meaning that all of these handgunners will hopefully have to get pretty close to us before they'd have to come over this lip before they get line of sight to our chaps just on slightly the other side of it. We also have our berserkers here, our wolves, our skin wolves in hidden in the forest. Let's just slow things down because this battle goes pretty quickly. We've got our trolls in our chariot on the right hand side along with our axe throwers. We've got our marauder horse masters in the back on vanguard, and they are coming straight for the mortar. Now, our plan is working rather deliciously here in that we have our two skin wolves and all of their cavalry seems to be about to go through the same forest that our skin wolves are in. Now, rather foolishly, I actually forgot our entire leadership over here and I forgot they were there. So we eventually pulled them into the battle, but not for a while. So here we go. The gunners are down there and so they can still fire at our guys here, which I think is what they're aiming at. And we have our chariot here just trying to go around this unit of great swords, go around the side. We've moved our trolls back a little bit. And they sent straight in Empire Knights, but we've got our javelins just at the back here, lobbing down at them. Terrible idea, terrible engagement with javelins in the back for Empire Knights. And here we go, ambush sprung. There go our skin wolves. Now, skin wolves will be able to fight Empire Knights, just basic Empire Knights, not too much trouble at all. So we pulled back this unit, and as you can see, the gunners can't really shoot anything anymore. So they're having to climb up the hill, buying us a bit of time for our chariots and our marauder horsemen just to nail the two handgunners we've caught so far. One of them has made it onto this hill here. We've got our trolls engaged with this Empire captain. The other one snuck through, and he does do a little bit of carnage onto our axe throwers because we don't really see him for a while. But so far, we're handling those well. These great knights, the AI actually did something quite clever here. They used their Empire knights to block the charge of my berserkers and my marauders into their greatswords, which are a much better matchup. Grenadiers coming in, doing some damage to us. Pulling out our skin wolves, because that's not a great engagement for them against Empire greatswords. So they're just going back against the cav. Our horse masters are caught by cavalry here. But our skin wolves aren't far away, and we kind of decimated the rest of the cavalry. So we're going to finish off this unit here and get the missiles. Two of one. Chariot coming in the back. And our boys at the front are doing remarkably well. If you look at the great swords, their leadership's down. We're casting magic on them. We did a pit of shades that did a huge amount of damage to them before. Now these trolls are doing well just by holding off two units of great swords by themselves. And we have their general in here somewhere, but we've got the berserkers in there and they'll be happy with that engagement, especially once berserk kicks in. So let's speed things up again. My skin wolves, my cav, my chariot, clearing up the backfield. And just if you look at the power bar now, it's going in our favor. And will only increase as we clear up more of this cavalry. Those trolls are starting to suffer a little bit now, but they're doing okay. This captain's almost killed by our axe throwers, which I'm pretty impressed by. And he breaks, and that kind of shatters the rest of the army. I think the general went as well. So there we go. And then from here on in, it's just a chase down and a murder. Our boys performed remarkably well. All right, that went kind of better than we hoped. We did kind of miss out on an Empire captain just absolutely massacring our axe throwers. But apart from that, it went pretty smooth. We managed to limit their knights' effectiveness, shut down most of their handgunners. The greatswords did almost nothing. All in all, solid performances. Solid kills from the champions, from berserkers alike. Even the Javs getting in some solid kills. Great performance from the skin wolves in the woods there, just ambushing all that cav that came for us. And, oh wow, look at that. Chaos Marauder champs getting huge amounts of kills off those handgunner units chasing them down in the back, and the chariot as well. Even the trolls putting up huge numbers. Alright, a huge amount of the kitty afterwards. Alright, now we need to move Frog a bit. I don't think we'd lose any units if we just did this one straight away, so I think we're going to do that. Oh no! I spoke too soon, we lost one of our wolves, damn it! Alright, in camp for a little while. We don't want to lose another one of our wolves. I mean, we could wait here and just recruit another unit. I think we'll do that. So there's no way anything else gets there quickly enough. We still have a space. Why do we still have a space? Oh, for the Mistwalkers eventually. It's going to be a while till we get to an outpost. Now, Eric, your boys did well. Let's have you finish off that army. Now we're going to raise this one. 34. 2. 16. I think this one goes to the serpent. I keep forgetting the order in which I meant to be doing these. I think this one goes to the hound and then the serpent. We'll go around like that. Hound and then the serpent. Here's some warriors. You do also have some champions, so we'll give you that. Give you that. That's kind of the way it looks like it's going, isn't it? Norsken Giants, Marauder Chariots, Cavalry, Warhounds. Don't even have any spearmen in the army, so we'll just do that.
The four corners.
Now Wolfric's back up to 100%. King Luan again, eh? I'm just gonna auto-resolve this. Oh, damn it.
Ready.
Get back into her own territory to heal for a bit. We'll recruit those replacement spearmen next turn. What else are we missing in this army? That would only take us to 19. Oh, we lost those warhounds ages ago. 8 turns still till they're back. All right, Eric can't move. He's done his job. How are you doing? You catch up with Eric over here. Oh, I have a little Kislev army. We'll go back up here, then we'll strike out in Norden, then we'll decide what to do with Eric from there. Hockland's still alive. They don't usually last this long. Does anybody like me? Not a single person. The Wood Elves don't mind me rampaging around. They're pretty cool with it. Do you guys want to trade? No. Alright. End the turn. This seems like the most advanced skin wolf. Level 9. So I'm guessing this is Wolfric's one. So I'll give you Vicious Assault.
I will not obey. You dare seek my order?
What are you doing, Kislev? Yep, you managed to kill that guy again. Well done. Oh, and you killed him proper. Nicely done. What? We'll come back over here. Raid. Why can't he move? Guard veteran.
I eat my enemies.
How can you not move, buddy?
Lord of the Monster Horde. I eat my enemies.
That might be a glitch. Frick, a lot of your lads are suffering.
On the move. Done and done. My challenge undenied.
You have about enough cash for 10 turns. Having my guy stuck for 5 is a pain. Like, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this the other way around. Marienburg, can you build anything else yet? No. Oh no, the tower we needed to make into a kind of recruitment base, didn't we? For marauders or for monsters? That's the question. Let's say for marauders, and we can make the one to the far east the one for monsters. Which means I actually might have to destroy this building. And this one. That's a shame. All right. I forgot that's what we were doing there. Ultra spawns, we'll build that back up again. Don't you want to build any of those? I could build that. You can't find where you are. Let's end the turn. Cavalry charge bonus. And a trading bonus, but we have nobody who likes us enough to trade.
Tribesmen, gather.
Another couple of turns, they can move off. Oh, you can't move because you're recruiting. That's what's going on.
Right.
3 turns for Frog. Recuperate a bit, then we'll hit Norden next turn. You lads are fine. Let's do this, because I think are we out of monsters? No, we still have the Shaggoth one to do. Which, once Wulfric has his other spearmen, we'll probably do that. There you go, build up all of you. 3 turns, let's just try and power through them. Still, Karl Franz does not bother us.
Yes.
2 more turns. Alright, we're still actually healing over here anyway, so don't mind that too much. Eric. You need to be our moneymaker, buddy.
Tremble.
Alright, we'll deal with that next turn.
Understood.
Now just raid it. And recolonize Zoizenk, which is a terrible idea.
Savages.
What? We'll move you next turn. Everybody else is busy. Should we be concerned for Marienburg? Not at the moment. Defenses at Lyonnais are light. Okay. That's not my problem. All right, Eric. And go back into camping. Nice. One more turn, eh? I'll probably be back up to near enough full health by the time you're back up. And gold mine's still there. Build some defenses.
My challenge undeniable.
Where's the other guy? Ragur. Let's get you back on double motion to Winterpyre. Could give him stand or die. The chariots one's probably pretty good. Give him lightning strike. Might get us out of trouble from time to time. Unnatural healing as well.
Tribesmen gather.
Okay, Britannia definitely building up their forces for something. Let's do that. We're not about to recruit any others. Okay, now we're getting into the territory where we actually need to start doing stuff again. Let's build this for public order. Probably need it. One more turn before Wolfric can even move. Nice. Let's move you past it now. And you can raid.
Winter Tooth!
do that next turn. Wulfric Stark. Eric, let's have this dedicated to a god. I think next is the serpent. It's still a crummy army at Middenheim even. I think that's where Eric might head next. Big payday.
I refuse.
All right, one more turn. Rebels might move this turn. Don't do it, rebels.
I've little time for talking.
Moussillon, what do you want? No. I didn't even know we were at war with you.
Lord of the Monster Horde. Killing at last.
Don't make me lose my dogs again. Good. Now let's raise this. We just went serpent, so we go for crow. Stop giving away money. Did that say all provinces? Hold on. All provinces? That is nuts! That's a terrible trait. How do I get rid of that? Jeez. Hard to hit, I guess. I'm just so thrown off by that trait.
Battle time is feeding time.
Alright, finally, Wulfric can move. Now, the problem is, we have a full army here, and they will march. Who's this, Ulbrich?
To the four corners.
And they will march on us as soon as we leave this province. But we have to deal with this rebel army. How quickly can you move, Ulfric? Still fairly solid defense there. No need to waste manpower on that.
Not a chance. The eagle guides
me. Oh.
I refuse.
Yeah, we can handle that full stack. Boris, come for us.
Well, and ravage. Carnage at last. Understood.
No, ultra spawns, you're fine. Pop the lovely obsidian again. What are the Bretonians going to do?
Seek my order.
Come on, Marienburg rebels. You're going to do it, aren't you? Oh, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hounds can chase down one of them. They are going to be a problem. How much damage can Outriders really do is the question. Four Outriders is too much for me to be able to really deal with. The champions, my trolls can take out these captains. Let's quick save it. I don't fancy our chances, but let's fight this one. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we go against this Empire troop. I don't fancy our chances. I think they just have too many Outriders, but we're going to go for it. So here's the strategy. We have our sacrificial unit up front, and they're just going to take all the fire from all of these missiles in the back and the mortar, hopefully, and then we can engage the great swords with some of our armor piercing. But the AI looks like it's not as dumb as it once was and is actually firing in our lines behind this troop, or they're just benefiting from the fact that there's a delay in their firing and they're actually just missing these guys and hitting the line behind them. We do have the mammoth, but because we have so few quick mobile troops to chase down their missiles, we're gonna have to use the mammoth on missile duty. And he's getting a bit peppered, but I'm not too worried about that really. So we've got our dogs going around the back to deal with the mortars, as you can see. Our front lines are now clashing. They've got all of their outriders on the flanks. Looks like our guys are trying to have a shoot off of these guys. But I didn't have them on skirmish, unfortunately, and these halberdiers caught them. We have our trolls going for these gunners, and they're running, so the trolls are going to get through the gap there. But we have spears versus spears here. We tried to get our armor piercers in here against the greatswords. But the great swords are just good against marauders. They're just going to be killing a lot of marauders, and they have an empire captain in here as well with them. Over here, we have our mammoth in against all sorts of missiles here, doing some good killing. Our dogs have dealt with one of the mortars moving down the line. The bravery of these chaps here, just from a pack of wild war mutated warhounds, like, just to next while all their mates are fighting, is incredible. It's like, just don't look to your right, lads. Just keep it going. So we have these guys split up. I have the Feral Mammoth chasing down the gunners. Have some trolls who got in behind the lines chasing down these quarrelers. So the trolls are doing good work chasing stuff down. The dogs have done good work getting rid of the several mortars there. But on the front lines, our guys are just getting peppered by the outriders. Let's have a quick look here. 32, 10, 13, 14 over here. 29 already. They're getting the kills and they're breaking away. Our champions there, our general even, already broken by two Empire captains and the Greatsword unit. Now, we just didn't have the trolls to spare. Now, I'm actually quite happy engaging their general here. Hopefully, the trolls can actually kill him. Because I think just a generic Empire general taking on trolls, I think they can actually kill him most of the time. We've got our dogs now moving on to the missiles, chasing down these unit of quarrelers. Now, for the most part, we have managed to successfully shut down their missiles. But with their outriders just on the flanks, peppering, you can just see the health of our front line is all but drained. One unit of spearmen still kind of holding on, but our troops started to waver and break. 65 kills, 10 kills, 48 kills. See, they're just racking them up. And the Outriders aren't even close to out of ammunition yet. The Mammoth is still being... I mean, I think the Mammoth is slightly wasted during this battle, chasing down this unit of gunners. The Dogs did well. They've kind of finished with them, and now they're being fired on by these guys. They're going to keep chasing them down. Now, our Trolls even begin to break here, because one of the Empire Captains came in, but he distracted us long enough for their General to actually escape, which was very annoying. And now I see our front line have just been absolutely slaughtered by those greatswords. If we'd had the Trolls in there and the Mammoth in there, it would have made all the difference, but they weren't able to shut down the missiles quickly enough, simply because of the amount of kills these Outriders got. And it would have been a complete waste of time chasing these guys down. We just wouldn't have caught them with anything we have. So, I mean, stuff stays in for a bit longer. The Dogs get in there against the Gunners. I figure maybe we can scare them a bit if we kill their general. So I try and send these Trolls who are kind of on the verge of breaking. They break a bit. They don't break. The Mammoth's doing fine against these Spearmen. But without any of the other units, the Mammoth's leadership will start to go down, as it has now under fire from these Gunners as well. Then you have the Outriders just chasing down and shooting any troops who even come back. If they last for a little bit, they're going in against Greatswords. You'll just cut them down, and then they'll just break immediately again. There we go. Now, we do even try and send our Mammoth in against their General, just to get that General kill. But he's facing the wrong way, all his animations are going in the wrong direction. And he's like keeps getting stunted by being under fire from these quarrelers. Not stunted even, having his whatever that animation is. Where he just ends up like just taking a hit. And then the Mammoth broke. And that was it. As we figured, it was just those Outriders. Couldn't do much against them, and the Greatswords did some great killing against our basic Marauders. So that didn't go very well at all. 133 for a unit of Outriders. That's got to be some kind of record. 115, our Mammoth did okay, mainly chasing down missiles, but really needed it in the middle of the fight there. Hounds did great chasing down missiles. The Trolls did okay before being scared away, because they're Trolls. We shut down the Mortars fairly quickly. The Captains, again, getting big kills between them as well. The General went up against the Trolls early and kind of lost out quite a lot. And we did a lot of damage to their army, just not enough. But hopefully we hurt them enough that now Eric, who I hope is still around this area somewhere, I think so if I remember correctly, should be able to deal with him. Oh, another fight for Marienburg against some rebels. Damn it. I don't want to have to keep fighting this battle for Marienburg over and over and over again. All right, what have we got? We've got horses. We've got the cav. They can kill most of the spears. We just have to make sure we chase down the infantry. All right, let's do this just in case anything goes wrong. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. So we've lined up our troops all like this to use the cover of this tree line against most of their missiles. So we're just trying to charge, try and cut them off so the missiles end up behind this tree line. And we don't quite make it there. As you see, they're starting to come through the tree line now. I can't see a lot of these troops, actually, because of the trees and because of this little ridge. So the idea is to have the Trolls on the edges of our formation so they can loop around the back and chase down some of these missiles. Our front line can handle Empire Spearmen, no problem, even our basic Marauders. So I'm not worried about that at all. And we've got the Cav on that side and the Dogs on that side to, again, loop around and just shut down all of these missiles that they have. The Empire Captain might be a bit of a problem, but I'm pretty confident we can kind of deal with him. So I think these are the champions, yeah, with their tattoos, against some very brightly colored Marienburg spears. We got the spears to engage their spears on the edge. The trolls come round, looking to chase down these missiles. We've got our Marauder Cav coming through on that side, already caught a unit of Quarrelers. On the other side as well, we've got our dogs coming round. Oh, heads are rolling. It's just going horrifically. And these are all just missiles with no support of any of their infantry, as you can see. All just Quarrelers getting massacred by our chasing units. We got a unit of spears in here to surround, just to help this flank go a little bit quicker. Everyone else is holding. Our own defensive general is actually suffering a little bit against this Empire general, which isn't great. But the rest of our lines are doing just fine. They'll grind them all down. We moved our axe throwers to the edge to get a few shots off. And now we're really kind of just shattering all of their missiles. Most of them are dealt with. And so at this point, we can turn our trolls around and be like, lads, go kill that general. So that's what these boys are about to try and do. We pull these trolls back eventually as well. And we just use the dogs and the calf to chase down the remaining troops. Not sure why these guys are going so slowly, just taking their time. But yeah, for the most part, our front line's holding on that left-hand side where we got the surround of their extra unit of spears. We've completely wiped them out. On the right, we're just kind of grinding it down. Our axe is going in to help out as well. And I'm pretty sure at some point these trolls get in the mood for some action. Here we go. Roar! And they just smash through to try and track down this Empire general. And the morale of all those spears who they just ran through to get to the general collapses. They shatter. The general shatters, and the whole rest of the army shatters as well. Now, we just really spend the rest of this battle, which has a bit more time on it, I believe. Yeah, 3 minutes, just chasing stuff down. So I'm not going to make you guys watch me chasing stuff down. So let's go to the battle results screen. Alright, that went pretty smoothly. Our champions getting some great kills there, along with our... Actually, everyone getting some pretty solid kills, apart from our axe throwers. 104, 106, 116, 78, 27, 137. Solid all round. Their best standout was their general, who got 53 kills single-handedly. Good for you, Adolphus Huss. And we didn't... Well, I suppose we shut down their Quarrelers. Some of their spears did alright. Yeah, none of their missiles did anything. 151 from the Norse controls, that's very solid. VIPs, or MVPs, that's what I'm looking for, not VIPs. MVPs to Norse controls. Alright, can we finally get a turn again? ...2211, don't like that at all. Alright. So, let's check the Monster Hunter. Done that. In progress. Oh, we're still looking for the... Oh, yeah, we can do that one whenever we just have to teleport. Skin Wolves, Norskin Ice Wolves, Norskin Warhounds. Income from post-battle loot plus 10%. That's pretty solid. Roll this gas. Minus 20, okay, that's pretty solid. We should probably go and try and take Mogliano. We're not really building anymore. This one's completely inconvenient, because by the time you've gone down to get the dwarves to go to Karazakarak, there's no way you'll still be needing to build stuff. I think that's unrealistic, that one. Plus 25% weapon strength, all buildings, Altdorf. Vampire counts. Refreshment rate. Green skins. Whole load of post-battle stuff. We'll try. I think that's probably the next biggest city we can probably get. But let's finish this one off, why not? Just because we can.
I see death.
Frog, let's get you a bit closer.
I out of my way!
We do want you regenning, so let's get you into you this. Well, that's Wolfric. Where are you? What were you doing? Oh, you were trying to come down here to Marienburg to help out. We were a bit worried over here. And we don't have a huge amount of money. Castle Artois is pretty battered. There's a huge army there now, I think, though. Corone probably needs some reinforcements. I mean, now we've beaten that army. I'm not 100% bothered about what happens there, really. That's been built up a little bit. We could head into Helmgart to try and get some money off there. But we should be leaving this bit so vulnerable. And have we even done his quest battle yet? No, we haven't. So now I don't really hack. We kind of want to finish off this rebellion. Oh, interesting. An upgrade on the normal Berserker. Plus 10 for the whole of the Lord's Army. Plus 4 for Marauder Berserker units. That is solid. I need that one. Sorry, that's just too good. Oh, we're gonna have to get up one of these money ones. Bonus versus large, plus 5 melee attack. Vanguard. That's pretty useless, actually, for the people who can use it. I mean, that one's all right. So we'll get rid of this. Gotta get that. Okay, now to scare the Bretonian army into coming back here. We need to move here. So then if they leave, they know they're leaving their castle unguarded. That's my thinking there, guys. All right, what else we got going on? You're camped out. Eric? Where were we sending you, Eric, and why? Oh, to Middenheim for some cash. That's what we were doing. Oh, actually, it almost might be better to give Eric that follower. Because look at, he has so many berserkers. But I suppose it's only a leadership buff to berserkers, isn't it? Let's go back and have a quick look. Plus 10. Oh no, for Marauder Berserker units. Alright. You've won me over. We'll get rid of that. We'll give you that back. And we'll give the Berserker to Eric. Because he just has so many Berserkers. Get rid of that. Give you that. We'll probably get rid of that now. Give him one of these rubbish banners. I'll give you a mountain scale, actually. Get you moving around a bit quicker. Let's do this, Eric. Oh no, that's going to take a turn. Nightmare. All right.
Into the fray.
I'll ignore that. If they send that full stack down, we might be in trouble. Not a lot of trouble, because it'd be a battle outside the gates, which would actually suit us pretty well. They would have 3 extra greatswords. They don't have any greatswords in this army. They would have Cav, and we don't have a lot of anti-Cav. We have the Skin Wolves. And they'll take the Empire Knights pretty easily, actually. Yeah, I'm okay with that if they come down. Now, Wolfric, your army is pretty good. If I hadn't double moved, I would have teleported and done the battle. But let's just end this turn and see what happens. happens. I don't want Kislev coming back anytime soon. Don't want to spend that money. You still have the level 2. You were on a level 3. Gonna spend that just in case. It might be a huge waste, but what the hell. Not gonna spend that. What are you gonna do, Britannia?
How about this?
Oh, you want peace, do you? No, thank you. Now what are you gonna do? Absolutely nothing.
I've little time for talking, but much time for killing.
Middenland, eh? You want peace? No, we're about to raid your city, so no. I may not be a nice chap, but I'm an honest nice chap, Boris. Sevilla, nice. Alright, let's get that money. Nice.
Northmen come.
Now Slasmund. Raid and recover. I'm actually happy to let Middenheim actually almost recover. Because if they just keep building the city the same way, that's a nice little loot pile we've got there. Wulfric, we're going to move you. Not that far, just a bit closer.
Move.
And then are you raiding camp again? Try and heal up. Next turn, you'll take that city.
Four corners.
Now, Wulfric. What should we do with you, my little friend? That town's not really worth taking. Some peasants. I mean, it's all just peasants.
Do you take me for a chum?
I think we need to get rid of Castle Artois just so we can keep going a little bit. And then eventually we can take on the Red Duke. But for now, I tell you what, guys, what we're going to do. Is we're going to fight this battle here. Dragon Ogre's Great Horn. I think we are. Why can't we teleport? Alright, but we're going to actually save that until the next episode, guys. So next episode, we are fighting the Dragon Ogre Shaggoth. Let's just teleport across there now. Alright, this is what we're going to be doing. Fighting Shaggoths and Manticores. Alright, that should be a lot of fun. So stay tuned for that, guys. As always, a huge thank you all for watching. And a special thanks to my patrons, Huli, Reese, Colin, Mateus, Samuel, Matthews, David, Peter, Sign of the Emperor, Niblitz, Caliph, Nigel, Hankster, Zelha, and James. Thank you guys for supporting me, and hope to catch you all on the next one, guys. Alright, bye.